As children of God, we are expected to follow His will, abide by His laws, and believe in His words. We are made with a purpose not only to bring forth God's word in the world through reality, but also to live our life to the fullest while preserving the order and creation He had made. We are given the opportunity to be called to care for creation because we are blessed with the ability to make choices, be responsible for our actions, our ability to think and love, which inherently separates us from other creatures on earth. Through these God-given attributes, we have the capacity to provide aid and assistance to all of God's creation. But
we choose to defy. The world is ravaged by our actions. We were tasked to love, but in a way we hate. We were molded to be stewards of creation, yet we were devastators. We have caused so much pain in everything and everyone that somehow we don't really care anymore. What went wrong that reached to this point?
This is our goal. We were formed and tasked with only one thing: to be stewards of creation.
Agent M, you got orders. The mission is a go.
Mission 1. To live life is to live with compassion. We must use our voices to address the injustices that are happening constantly in our lives. As teens, the catalysts of change, we must do our best to address discrimination and unjust killings of animals and humans through joining youth organizations, using literature, and most importantly, praying on behalf of others. Mission 2. Sharing is caring. Proverbs said, "Whoever brings blessings will be enriched, and one who waters will himself be watered." It is with charity that we exhibit generosity and helpfulness towards the needy and suffering as we go to seek change and relief in this materialistic world. We teens are called to share, not just in objects, but the way of signifying the reciprocal love between God and man that is made manifest in unselfish love of one's fellow being. Giving smiles, volunteering, and giving alms to the most needy is a way of charity. Mission 3, above all, love. Love is manifested at all things, including the first two missions. But this doesn't only limit itself to making a change for the people, it can also be shown through the care of our nature. As young agents of change, our efforts to protect and defend the ecology will help us understand how crucial it is to protect the natural resources that support life on Earth. This can be manifested in things like planting trees, cleanliness, and nurturing or respecting wildlife.
Requesting all agents, gather at point 777 immediately.
The motivation for us and agers is to know the idea of respect and being good to one another is really reflected in God's eternal law.
As for myself and other teenagers like you, we are proud to be called the children of God, as we are expected to follow His will, abide by His laws, and believe in His words.
We are made to bring forth God's word and live life to the fullest, preserving the order and creation God has created.
Because we came to respect life and creation, because that is what we ought to do as human beings and as the children of God.
With the commitment of teenagers, not only me, but you and other teens are entrusted with the responsibility to uphold the significance of creation and respect in the aspect of God's will to create this world. Because the idea of love can renew and rebuild a world where God calls it the promised land of all creatures.
Did we accomplish our mission? I think we did.
No, it's not.
If we can do it, so can you.